In this video, we are discussing linking PDF files into Revit. So to start with, I'm gonna talk about how to create the PDF file in the first place. So we have here a typical floor plan. What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually turn on some dimensions so I can use those in my discussion here. So I'm going to unhide those dimensions that we have here. And then I'm going to, so this, as you can see, these dimensions are given from the, on the large part of the building, the width of the building, 48 feet and fraction, and the length of the building is about 260 feet. Okay, so also I'm gonna make sure that I'm gonna zoom in on this floor plan. I am in the view right now, in the floor plan view, not on a sheet. And therefore, I need to make sure that I zoom in and fill out the entire view range here. So I may want to do like a zoom window and kind of zoom really tight on that. This will give me more real estate here, if you will, and more accuracy. I also need to probably turn on my fine level of detail in the floor plan, just in case I need to show more detail. And then after that, I will go ahead and use the export, the file menu, export to PDF. In the PDF, my first export will be not to scale. So I'm going to call it NTS, floor plan NTS, and I'll select the folder where it should go in. And I make sure that I have the zoom size fit to page because it's not to scale. And I will pick a sheet size 30 by 42. I can pick the raster quality to be high in this case. And I can go to color or grayscale. I will hide any reference planes, any work planes, hide scope boxes, crop boundaries, and unreferenced view tags. I will also select, I don't want to keep the orientation to automatic. I will select the landscape orientation of the floor plan. So the important thing about this export is that it's not to scale and it is fit to page. I'll go ahead and export that, and I will, I don't want to use the settings for a future session, so I'll say no. Now, since I already did that before, I'm going to go ahead and just override that. It doesn't take long to export the PDF. Now, the second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to export the same floor plan to PDF, but this time I'm going to zoom to 100%. And I will call this scaled instead of the NTS, okay? So everything is the same, center placement, but the zoom is 100%, and I change the name to scaled. Go ahead and export. Nope, don't save. All right, so one thing that I did not mention, that is, we did export the view itself, not the visible portion of the current view, which means that if you were to do right click zoom to fit, you know, there's still some margin over here on the right side and the bottom, which adds to the net to scale problem. Okay. We'll go ahead and close this project. I will use a brand new project in Revit to open the architectural template and go ahead. This project is renewed, so there's nothing in it. I'll use the insert menu, and I have a choice between linking PDF or importing the PDF. It's usually not a good idea to import anything into Revit unless it's a typical detail and you would use import CAD, but importing a PDF does not make any sense because you're not gonna keep it there forever, right? We're gonna use it and then remove it when we're done with it. So we'll go ahead and link it as a PDF link. And I, as I said before, I will use the night scale first. And these are actually the old ones. Let me delete the old ones. Okay, so we have the NTS and we have the scale. So the NTS first. And it gives me the option of previewing this and setting the resolution to from 72 dpi dot per inch to 600 dpi dot per inch. I'll select the 600 dpi because I wanted to make sure I have a high resolution so I'm able to draw my floor plan in Revit on top of that PDF. So while we're waiting for this, I'm going to talk about what's the next step. Next step is to make sure we measure some dimension in the floor plan in order to find out if it's to scale or not. Now we know this is not to scale, so we're going to have some issues. So the solution is to actually scale the drawing to before we can use it. Okay, so it came in. I'll go ahead and place it with a click in the middle of the screen. And it is looks pretty sharp. Let's wait for this to finish. Because it's a 600 dot per inch, it may take a minute before it actually is placed completely. So I'm gonna zoom out a little bit and then I'm gonna try to do a quick check here on the scale, right? So this is the 48 feet dimension. I'll go ahead and use the measure tool in Revit in the modify menu, and I'll pick something. Okay, so right now I can't even click on it, but I'm gonna just get close as possible, and I see what we get. So right now this is measuring 52 feet instead of 48 feet. So we are off. Okay, we are off. Okay, let's measure the other dimension. And I'm being very, very, very precise, right? I'm gonna zoom in really close, click right there at the tip of this dimension and in the center of this dimension. And next time we'll use a different technique. All right, so this is going to the perpendicular to this. So this, we can measure it that way, obviously. So let me try again. Measure tool. This time I'm going to go from the center of this dimension tick mark to the center of this dimension tick mark. And the dimension is 283 feet in 2 inches. Let's see, does it match? You can see both dimensions side by side here. It doesn't match. The 260 and 283 don't match. Therefore, the not to scale it was not a good idea. Now, if I was going to actually do this, I would, here's what I would do. I would right click zoom to fit, click on this, and I would enable snaps, okay? And then we're gonna tell Revit, okay, we're gonna scale this drawing, and I'll usually pick the long dimension, but because we are doing a quick video here, I'm gonna select the short dimension. So Revit's gonna actually able to click on the end of the dimension line or here, but you know, this is good enough. You know, I can actually do an SI, yep. So intersection, snap intersection, that's probably a good idea. And then come over here and a snap intersection. SI keyboard shortcut. And the next dimension would be to actually type it in, right? So the actual dimension is 48 feet, one and 3/4 of an inch. And hit enter on the keyboard. Now it's to scale, okay? Let's measure it again. Scale. SI keyboard shortcut to snap to the tick mark. Come over here. Same thing. SI snap to the tick mark. and the dimension is 48 feet, 1 3/4 of an inch. As long as the scale, I can proceed with it. Now, if I were to link in my scaled drawing, scaled PDF, I don't have to do any of that stuff. Okay, so the trick was to enable snaps in the PDF settings. Okay, that was a trick. So we'll go ahead and proceed. If I were to link in the scaled drawing, then I wouldn't have to do any of that stuff, right? So I think it's pretty obvious. We'll go ahead and create a 3D view here in Revit. And we will tile the views side by side. And right now we can't see anything in 3D. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my fine level of detail in both situations here. And I'm gonna try to select a wall that is convenient. For example, what is the size of this wall? Okay, let's go ahead and measure this. The modify menu. Okay, this is kind of, we don't even know what that means. So I'm gonna go to center of this line, to the center of this line. And as you can see, the distance is 4 7/8, which is a typical commercial partition with a metal 3 5/8 metal stud and one and a gypsum mold board on each side. Okay, that's what we have here. Perfect, so I can now proceed with wall command in architecture menu and select the pick lines tool. And if this is going to, we're gonna assume this is gonna be the finished face interior of the wall as a location line. And we will come over here to the type selector and select a 4 7/8 partition. And again, I will use the pick lines tool and I will highlight this line over here, and it looks like it found it, right? So if I were, oh, this is in the case of centerline. Okay, so I'll actually go back to the finished face interior, and as you can see, as I highlight my cursor or hover my cursor over the edge of the wall, Revit is showing me the center of the wall, which is really where the wall is going to go, which is looks perfectly accurate. When I see the preview, I'll go ahead and click, and as a result, you can see I can see the wall over here in the 3D view. So that wall is being placed accurately, but it doesn't continue to over here. So let me go ahead and turn on my shadows, so you can see which walls have been placed. Right, so this wall has been placed, the others have not been placed. So I'll make sure that I for the remaining part of this exercise, I'll make sure that I can see the preview accurately before I proceed. Otherwise, I'm taking the risk of not having the proper alignment with the existing drawing. I will not need to put a wall here because this would be bad drafting practices. What I really want to do is extend the wall to the end of the wall over here. So let me continue. It looks like this wall thickness changes. So again, you're gonna have to measure almost every wall to make sure that we have the right thing. For example, in this case, I will use the trim command to trim this wall with this wall because we want to extend over this door opening, right? So select this wall, and it extends nicely. And then of course, we will have to add a door here. So we use a door command, Revit, try to get as close as possible, you know, and I can use hit the space bar just to flip the door and then place the door, and the door opening is created. And that's how this is the best practice for importing and linking PDF drawings and scaling. Thank you for listening. Take care.